بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Your Excellency, Tun Dr. Muhammad, Mahathir Muhammad, Mrs. Mahathir Muhammad, distinguished guests and of the conference, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to take this moment an opportunity to thank with deep appreciation the Baradona Global Peace Organization for organizing this conference and for hosting, and also for the Malaysian authorities and the people of Malaysia for hosting and giving the victims of Iraq the opportunity from the American occupation, the opportunity to stand and tell the whole world the atrocities and the suffering they have been going through during this criminal occupation. Also, for giving us, the Iraqi people, the hope and support to stand and resist this occupation. And also to criminalize the people who initiated this aggression against Iraq. My presentation today is about the contamination of Iraqi territories and Iraqi population with depleted uranium and the health consequences that resulted from that contamination. The American administration and the UK administration, of course, have been waging wars for two decades on Iraq. And during these wars, they used all kinds of illegal weapons. They used cluster bombs, napalm, white phosphorus, depleted uranium, microwave. Practically, they made Iraq the guinea pig laboratory of their new generated weapons. So from that, as a result of using these weapons and with the economical sanction, they were also imposed both by those criminal administrations. The Iraqi people, the Iraq lost more than 2 million victims as a result of using these weapons with the sanction. What is depleted uranium? I will elaborate from what my colleague Maureen Loré, what she said about depleted uranium is a man-made radioactive heavy metal extracted from uranium ore when during the enrichment process to extract spent fuel for nuclear reactors. It is estimated that 70% of the uranium projectiles turn into uranium oxides. That means the aerosols will compose 70% of the mass of the depleted uranium in the bullets and the projectiles. The problem with the American occupation is for two decades they've been denying the health effects of depleted uranium on Iraqi population, on other populations practically in the world. They keep denying that for a good reason. The American administration and the Pentagon changed all this hazards, radioactive waste, into bullets. When instead of spending this much money to get rid of their radioactive waste arsenal in America, they changed it into bullets and into projectiles and bombs, and they are selling these bombs to other parts of the... So it is a billion-dollar industry. So they keep denying the Iraqi people their the damages they've been suffering during these two decades, and also even their veterans, the American veterans, are suffering from these weapons, but they keep denying that these weapons can cause this much health damage, and they always repeat that these are low-level radiations, and it's close to the natural background level, and it doesn't hurt this much. Dr. Rosalie Bartel, an epidemiologist, 3 years experience in the field of low-level radiation, explained the potential harm of depleted uranium weapons. After the inhalation of the oxides of DU, which is nanoparticles that is less than 5 microns in size, it crosses the lung-blood barriers and gain entrance to the cells of the body. They create free radicals as a result of a heavy metal. So it has two impacts. It has an impact as a radioactive material, and it has another impact as a toxic heavy metal within the human body. So it creates more, the toxic effect will get rid of the antioxidants within the human body, and there, this way there will be more free radicals in the human body. Free radicals can also totally disturb the folding process and the manufacturing of the molecules, molecular proteins within the human body, which is sequenced by the DNA and manufactured by the RNA. Accumulation of this misfolded protein leads to neurodegenerative disease, whatever, the Parkinson's disease, and early onset Alzheimer's diseases. Other health effect that was noticed within not only the Iraqi veterans, Iraqi people, and the American veterans, what they call the Gulf War syndrome, that they have the damage within the immune system and hormonal system, disturbance of the thyroid function, mycoplasmal invasion into human cell, initiation and promotion of cancer and other kind of malignancies, teratogenic toxicity, which causes mental retardation, and congenital malformation. Also, the groundwater, the Gulf War veterans were 2 to 3 times are likely to report children with birth defects. Like in Iraq, birth defects rose to sixfold after 1995. And the Americans keep denying this is as a result of depleted uranium. Dr. Alexandra Miller and her team at the Armed Forces Radiological Research Institute in Pasadena, she also ran too many research that led to very important findings about the effects of depleted uranium. But they ran those experience on laboratory, vitro and vivo, and they found to assess morphological transformation, genotoxicity, and chromosomal aberration within the human, within these animals. Published data of the results also have demonstrated that depleted uranium exposure in vitro to immortalize the cells, the planted cells, and it causes neoplastically transformation, mutagenic and genotoxic, and induce genome instability. It's all related to transformation in the chromosome and DNA of the of these animals. Other results showed that exposure to embedded